with us, Undersecretary Jose Mari Oquiñena of the Presidential Communications Operations Office, Arroyo lawyer Ferdinand Topacio, Professor Edmund Tayao from the UST Political Science Department, and Attorney Adel Tamano, an expert in constitutional law and anchor of ANC's Tamano Perspective. Professor Tayao, how is this being viewed by the ordinary man?
Well, the ordinary man, of course, would always see it as, doing a favor for them because obviously the former president really doesn't enjoy any public support anymore, no? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's obvious. But what's interesting also is that expert opinions, whether from the legal side or from an academic side, would always be somehow different from the way the administration sees how to proceed, no? As far as this issue is concerned, meaning that most constitutionalists would see it as an affront to the basic institution, the political institutions that we have in this country.
And you don't see the ordinary man beginning to question
I don't think that the ordinary man sees it as something that has repercussions in the future, which mm-hmm. is, of course, not necessarily something that's good. Uh-huh. Obviously, because if you look at the vantage point of not only ordinary man. I mean, I wouldn't want to delineate the difference between ordinary and the elite or what. But the thing is, as far as the ordinary man is concerned, he will always have to preference as far as his day-to-day necessities are concerned. So, and this is the one that is basic for him.
Yeah. Does it mean then that the ordinary man or elite has a greater chance now of getting justice because of what the president has said?
No, I don't think so.
It has nothing to do with that.
It
is all against
that.
The justice that they want to see,
yes,
meted on those who had.
For them, that's the danger always in a presidential system. It's not only in the Philippines. No? This is precisely why we've always wanted to proceed with institutional reforms. Because the president, just like Obama and all other presidents in different countries, he is seen as someone who's like a messiah who will do everything needed so that things will be different. Mm-hmm. But almost always, no, the president would eventually fall into a trap and mm-hmm. eventually dash cold water on these hopes of the people. So that's the danger. So assuming, for example, that the president gets to be successful in his assuming that his objective is to have a more compliant court and he gets to be successful, that's good. No? But the long-term effect as to how the institution suffered in terms of basic processes are concerned has been sacrificed. That's an entirely different story. Mm. Now, if he doesn't succeed, that's all the more a big danger.
What about the lower courts, the other courts, in the way they actually see this? A judge, the prosecutors, the public attorneys, and anybody and everybody that belongs to this branch of government. How are they looking at this, and how might it actually affect the conduct of their work?
Well, I think for lawyers, for me and for Ferdy, an attack on the judiciary is a bit of a, in a sense, a personal attack. Because we are officers of the court. In fact, I have friends who are judges, members of the judiciary, and they told me that at that forum where President Aquino gave that speech, that blistering speech, some of them actually wanted to walk out because they felt that it was improper. How does this affect on a practical basis? There is a danger if the courts become compliant. Because a court is supposed to be that impartial arbiter.
But doesn't a president always want a compliant court? Isn't that the end all and the be all of one's appointing?
I think the wiser view of a president should be that under our constitutional system, the court is not supposed to be the friend of the executive.
That's right.
Because it's system of democracy that we have is created on a principle of checks and balances.
Yeah.
So in fact, if the executive now is able to accomplish its end. I'm presuming it's an end. I could be wrong, but some say that the goal is to make a more compliant court. Then that's actually bad for democracy, because you need that push from the other branches of government to maintain that democratic system.
But you only impeach the Chief Justice, or do you impeach the entire court?
You know, that will really depend on what's going to happen. Impeaching one may send a message. It can be what we usually call the chilling effect.
That's right.
So that the other justices will say, no, we can't oppose the government's line on these other things. I think there's a danger. I think
you impeach each and every one of them.
You can also do that, but I think even impeaching just one. I think in fact, some people will disagree, but I've talked to some of my friends in Congress, and according to them, that in fact, even the current impeachment of Justice Del Castillo is somehow also connected, in the sense that it is sending a message that, look, if we can impeach Justice Del Castillo for plagiarism, then we can also impeach the others. And I know it will seem too esoteric, like the average, the fictional average person may not really care about the system of checks and balances. But I think if we look back in history and we go back to the Marcos time, it was precisely a rubber stamp court that allowed martial law to come in. If the court at that time had been more independent and pushed back, it may not have happened.
That's
why I keep saying that an impartial court that is part of the system of checks and balances is one of the most crucial aspects of a true democracy.
Okay, looking at the way decisions have been made by the appointees of Arroyo and the new appointees of Aquino, is this an impartial court?
I think that will always be a problem that every president will face.
That's right.
Every president will face court in which the previous president has appointed others.
Yes.
I think to expect the opposite of that, is something that's never going to happen. That's one. And number two, as a practitioner myself, you won't always win. That is how it is in a democratic system. And I think part of it is you just have to take your lumps. For example, this whole issue about creating the Truth Commission, and the executive felt that was the first blow against them. You could have just come up with a new executive order, fix whatever issues there were.
Amari,
on that point,
there are suggestions that maybe if they had the best of legal minds
that's another
to challenge a court already perceived by the administration as being compliant to the previous appointing power. Yeah. Was that something that is thrown into discussions? Maybe we should get?
I'm not part of a legal team in Malacañang, but I'm almost sure that pinag-aaralan naman to lahat. Mm-hmm. No? Like with the Truth Commission, for example, I'm sure meron namang legal other options or ganito. But the point here is that maybe we have to look at it also on things that are not too obvious. For example, why should we oppose a Truth Commission? Like what's the spirit behind? No, sasabihin may redundancy in this function, in that function.
No. I think the thing there that stuck out, that I remember there, is why put up a commission just for Gloria?
Equal protection clause.
I don't think it was just for Gloria. Hindi lang naman siguro yun na ganun yung purpose. Ang inaano lang dun, like the Truth Commission, precisely, ilabas yung katotohanan. And the same way that sabi nga ni Attorney Adel, na to look at it in a bigger perspective, hindi lang itong isang issue ng TRO, yung buo kabuuan, bakit nagkaganito. And in the spirit also of check and balance, if we say that the judicial system is the check and balance of the executive, sino mag-check and balance din dun sa isa? Siyempre, it goes both ways, no? So, feeling naman siguro ng executive, this is our way of checking you.
And balance.
Like for example, sabi nga kanina, is this really an impartial court? And sabi nga, that will never happen kasi there will be appointees from the previous. That's the point nga, because there are appointees of the previous and the previous. So, yung next government have to make sure na magpapadala ko ng message sa'yo, huwag ka namang partial. Mm-hmm. Dapat impartial ka. And siguro, itong impeachment, I'm not really privy to the details of the legal. Baka sinasabi na ito, mensahe din na hindi kayo stand alone at hindi kayo pwedeng, kayo lang ang singular voice ng truth. I mean, we want to also see na kung sinasabi niyong may mali kami, di ba? Tingnan din natin na
Sinasabi rin ba nung sa mga pananalita ng Pangulo na huwag niyong paniwalaan ang mga desisyon na lumalabas mula sa Korte Suprema?
That's implied.
Is that what
hindi
it
naman,
was
hindi
saying?
Naman niya, hindi naman niya sinasabi yun. Hindi naman.
At wala na sa kabinete ng Pangulo na nagsasabi, yes, we will abide by the decision of the Supreme Court. Meron ba kayong naririnig na ganun ngayon? Because obviously, the recent decisions and the resolutions of the court have always been either defied, di ba?
Hindi naman. Nandun pa din naman yung respeto sa institution. I think it's just a case-to-case, sabi nga ni Attorney Adel, na tingnan natin in a bigger perspective, wider perspective ito. Hindi naman to nilalahat ng Pangulo or ng gobyerno na wag na kayong maniwala doon, wala na yan, walang, hindi naman ganun. I mean, tinitignan lang ito at gaya nga, chinicheck lang at binabalance na sandali, mukhang may trending yung mga desisyon nyo na hindi tama. Baka pag-usapan natin tong trending na to at tignan natin bakit nagkakaganito, bakit naman may konting isang dalawang araw na palugit, hindi naman maibibigay. Yung mga ganun siguro na parang kasi mayroon ng trending na nakikita and parang hindi na ganun ka-open maybe for discussion or very partial na. So we have to do our obligation for the people na i-check din natin ito.
I should like to say something, Tina. No? After President Marcos, no, all the previous presidents already had setbacks with the courts. Mm-hmm. And well, of course, if only I did some research, I may be able to come up with specific cases. Particularly during the time of former President Ramos, no, there were very important cases, economic issues, even decided on by the court, as I remember it now. But still, what the executive did was not necessarily to attack the court, particularly the person, whether the Chief Justice or any particular member of the Supreme Court. So, to me, of course, I don't think that the President or the members of the Cabinet, I think they are educated enough not to say, huwag nyo nang sundin yung Korte, or whether Korte Suprema or what have you. But to me, that is already the implication. When you destroy the reputation of the person, already suggests to the public, you know, he's not fit to come up with decisions. Mm-hmm. That's the implication.
The henceforth, all decisions coming from this court
are suspect.
That's right.
Are suspect.
Kasi kung ikaw si Mayor later, nakita mo si RTC Court or si Municipal Trial Court, marami ka palang kalokohan din. No? So because of that, even without a proper case in court, the local chief executive may also say, you're no longer fit to make decisions.
What's stopping one
right.
from coming out as That's openly right. and as frontally as That's what right. The president did in his attack of the Supreme Court Chief Justice? The final stretch of talk back in a moment. Stay with us. So, last one.
Transitions lenses. Transitions adapt to changing light while protecting your eyes from glare and UV. Ask your eye care professional for Transitions lenses today.
Only the prime information.
administration. Lawmakers gave the green light to the budget bill that is worth 1.816 trillion pesos. Find out what areas could be affected by the storm.
And let's now talk to Pagasa weather forecaster.
The prime details.
Some people are stranded in different ports in the country.
All is well between President Aquino and his political advisor.
Filipino-Americans are joining the Occupy Wall Street movement.
Malacanang has a bit of advice for the Supreme Court after the tribunal's recall of its decision on the Facet case.
And the prime news of the day.
Demonstrators are setting up camp in Jersey City, New Jersey.
Weather Bureau Pag-asa warned residents in the Visayas and Mindanao.
A conspiracy to defraud the people and violate the law.
The biggest events deserve to be on Prime Time News. Prime Time on ANC. Weeknights, 8 in the evening on ANC. The ABS-CBN News Channel.